everyone. Carl here. Welcome back to Aeronautica. And yesterday, there has been a new update. They have added Norman, a large but barren desert island. It has a unique canyon rush race job that can be done with any aircraft at the risk of the player. They've also added its corresponding airport, Norman International, with 4 runways. They have added some generated static aircraft to most of the airports. I've seen one in Clarence, but they use random colors though. A new racing job. 4 new aircraft. A few remodels of the existing aircraft. And a few bug fixes. For today or tonight, we will perform a corporate job to the new airport. And this will be our plane. It will be the Gulfstream G650ER. And the statistics are on the bottom left corner of the screen, as usual. So, here is Norman International. It's just northwest of Valois and about 360 kilometers away. If it were a corporate flight, the rewards would be about 2.5 times as a normal transport. Yes, I would do the Valois to Ennexen, but that would be repetitive for a business jet. But let us do the... But for the purpose of this video, we will do a Valois to Norman. Shall we? And here is our Gulfstream. Back then, this doing the corporate flights was one of the best methods of making Wingz Points. A good amount of money in Wingz Points. But I think it's the supply drops are our faster method. Maybe even using supersonic transports. All right. Let us start the engines. And let us taxi to runway 2. And as usual, the taxiway is still slippery, but it's still a game issue. It's mentioned in the supersonic transport training video. But let's see if we can keep this from happening while pressing the 3 key. It's still ineffective, but at least we tried. We'll be taking half of the runway, since this is a supposed to take off at shorter runways. Alright. Well, let's better. Right, there we go. Right, that's the best we can align. Now let us temporarily reduce the graphics, since we'll be taking off with a lot of memory hogging. What is that? It's an A340-500 taking off from the apron and the grass. How unconventional. And wait, there's another one. A Saab 340B is heading towards me. Nope. Oh. So close. Right, so let's open the map and let's see where Norman International is. Oh, I think it's over here. So what can we choose? Shall we take runway 27 right or 27 left? So our flight plan should be like this. Let's stay sharp left turn. So let's take runway 27 left. Right? That seems fitting. And yes, the instrument landing system, 27 left, to help with the landing phase. And let's take off. Look at that large cirrus cloud. Flat as a pancake. And it just disappeared in front of our eyes. Looks like we're going against the jet stream. Our speed is in yellow. As expected, north-south flights are usually have favorable jet streams than southeast. Yes, it's from the northwest, but typically north-south. But we'll see. Yes. So in the expanded version of Wingz World V, Norman International used to be around here, and it's also a desert continent. I think it's fair that the developers move it on the opposite side of the islands, because we know there's already a Roblox International over here. Still fair enough. But still, they still need to take care of the slipping, as evident in the island, the continent of Avalon, before even trying to make new islands. And it looks like we're in the red now. And this is one of the examples of a static aircraft. In some of the airports, that there is a two Stolketten Nutset in one of the static aircraft at kites. I mean, a tuple of two Stolketten Nutset is one of the static aircraft at Kitesboro. You'll see for yourself, Clarence has that, Orkney Island has that, not sure for the others. You've seen that Valois doesn't for now, maybe it will. Okay, so we are 150 kilometers away from Norman, so let us start descending and slightly reducing the throttle. Let's try not going more than 30 meters per second of descent. Well, 50 meters per second of descent, though. Trying not to go into the overspeed. And there's Fishguard Island Airport. I think I can see some static aircraft over there on the apron. I can see four. combined with runway 27 as of now? Or do we need to turn more to the right? Let us now align with the runway guide for 27 left or runway 9 right. We should be close to around 160 to 170 knots at this point for a smooth landing. Let's turn on the navigational lights. It should be 5:30 p.m. game time. All right. November 4 or 5, Sierra November is on final runway 27 left. Norman Tower. And I can see runway 27 left over there. This guide isn't helping very much. I think it does now. No, we're a bit to the... What? All right. The wind indicator should be facing. It's about to converge. Or not. We'll stay there. Alright, let's now lower the landing gears. Good. We almost veered off the runway there, but look at that. Look at the skyline of Norman City. It does look like Las Vegas. And Norman International should be McCarran International? Maybe not. Or this should be McCarran International, this terminal here. I think the slipping is slight at this island. Look at that, highly detailed, as expected. Whoops, we're veering off the taxiway. There we go. And yes, there are no terminal lights. Why they have forgotten to do that? And look at these. This is the static planes at work. And since I'm the only business jet, I don't know how it'll affect. And we should be stopping at this fuel depot. And that was a corporate flight from Valois International Airport to Norman International Airport on the Gulfstream G650ER, the Ice Queen, has the unique name. And see you on the next video, everyone. What do you think? What is the inspiration of this airport over here? And what do you think? Is Baralku Airport small? There was a bug fix regarding jobs for large aircraft to this. It's probably the same as Ether Island? Or are they two different islands now? Oops, pressed the wrong button. Let's announce the server. Pardon my typing there. I don't know why is this happening. Just catches the microphone. Anyways, see you all in the next video. Hang on a minute. Do you see this wheel? It's tilted a bit. So much for the physics of this game. Whoever coded this plane might have forgotten to lower the nose.